Hi everyone, and welcome to this week's episode of Digital Film Dojo. Today's gonna be another one of these sit down and talk about a certain topic type of videos. So a popular topic that's discussed a lot in the film industry and online and anywhere really where film and video is happening is whether or not you should go to film school. You'll hear really a huge range of different answers you'll get to this question. There's people that will tell you no, it's a waste of money, or yes, you need to do it because X, Y, and Z. And coming from someone who did go to film school for 4 years, got a degree, and is working in the industry now, I'm actually someone who's not going to come out and come straight out and tell you should go to film school. In fact, I actually kind of get annoyed of the people who will have answers, who will have these kind of cut and dry answers to questions like this. Because really, when you talk about film school and breaking into the film industry, there's really a lot more nuances, and it really kind of differs from person to person whether or not it's a good idea or not. And that comes with a lot of different factors. And I don't think the best advice would be to straight up say, go to film school or don't go to film school. It's really something that you have to, if you're interested in this field, it's something you have to consider, and it's something that you have to take a lot of factors into account for. So in terms of going to film school, kind of speaking on my own experience and knowing the experience from others who have gone to film school, there's obviously a lot of pros you can get out of doing so. If you're someone who's not as familiar with the industry, is not familiar with the craft of filmmaking and making videos and all different aspects of it, film school is a really good opportunity to go and look to learn about everything having to do with the industry, learn everything having to do with pre-production, production, and post-production. You really can kind of get your feet wet and get a taste of every aspect of filmmaking and you know, video production. You can get a lot of experience doing so, you can build up your portfolio. Another great thing is there's a lot of other students, obviously, in the programs that all want to kind of do the same thing. So you have people you can talk to, have people that can work with you, and you all kind of have the same goal in mind. So you have this big pool of, you know, crew members you can pull from, people that can kind of help you, can kind of teach you and guide you on things you might not be as skilled at. I know personally, in my experience with film school, I learned a lot. I learned a lot from my teachers, but I also learned a lot from the students that were around me. You know, the students that may have had experience in an aspect of filming that I didn't know as much, I was able to help other students who didn't know as much about post-production editing, because that's kind of my forte. Every school is kind of different in the way that the student population is made up of, but I know in my situation, you know, we were a whole bunch of students who kind of wanted to do things, kind of all wanted to do the same thing, so we're all kind of in this together and kind of helping each other along the way. You know, every school is kind of different. It's not really the time for me to go into what film schools are best, because that's really up to you, and that's a whole other video on its own. Another great thing is, especially bigger film schools, they have a lot of connections that they can help you with in terms of finding a job, either in the area or in, you know, film hubs such as New York and Los Angeles. They give you kind of opportunity to kind of get a head start getting out of school and finding yourself a job and finding yourself a place in the industry, which is something that might, you know, be kind of difficult if you're going at it on your own. But, you know, with all those positives in mind, there's a lot of things that you do need to take into account if you are going to take a leap and go into film school. For once, obviously, the financial aspect of it. I was lucky enough to be in a situation where I didn't end up having student loans to pay off, so I wasn't in debt coming out of college. But I know this is a problem for a lot of people out there, and college is really expensive. And depending on how much financial aid you have and what school that you go to, you can be paying off student loans for a long time. And you just kind of have to consider if the experience that you're going to get out of it is going to be worth, you know, spending all this money, and if you're going to be in a situation where you're going to be able to pay off this debt and it's not going to pile up. The good thing is, if you go to a good enough film school and, you know, you put in the work and the effort, you're going to be able to get a job and you're going to be able to pay off those loans and really be able to move forward in your life and start doing things you want to do in the film industry. And going off that point, if you're going to go to a film school and you're going to, you know, go through the 4 years and studying and whatnot, you really have to put in the effort. The film industry is not the type of industry where you can kind of sit back and relax and glide your way through. You know, there's a lot of majors out there in college that people say that, oh, that's an easy major you can go through, and then, oh, film might be an easy major. I kind of just want a degree you know, go ahead, like I can just kind of glide my way through. Like you can do that. I mean, like there's plenty of people I've known that have done that. And it's kind of actually a shame to see that. What happens is a lot of people who end up doing this, you know, don't end up working in the industry and they end up taking different jobs in different industries, you know, that have nothing really to do with film. It's kind of taking away from the experience of the people who go to film school and want to learn and want to really try and stuff when there's people that kind of are, you know, slacking their way through and just kind of getting by with doing the minimal amount of effort. And it's just something that like this is the this is like your opportunity. If you're going to do this, that you really should really learn all the equipment you can learn. You should really kind of hone your skills in whatever area you want to pursue, and you really want to experiment a lot, and you really want to build up your portfolio, because that helps you a lot. Companies and film crews and stuff, you know, they have a lot of high expectations of the people who go to film school. The people that work in the industry, video production, film production, whatever, they're not going to hold your hand. If they're going to hire you, they expect you to come on, and they expect you to come onto the job, and they expect you to work and know what you're doing and have knowledge about what you're doing. And if you're kind of slacking off through your whatever film program you're doing, you're just not going to have that experience and knowledge. It's just kind of really important to, if you're going to go to film school, really make the best out of it. Because one, you're spending all this money, and two, you know, this is your golden opportunity to get all this experience, and you're going to be really ahead of the game coming out of college. It's really those people that I know that are getting the jobs right away and getting a lot of work right out of college, and it really shows. And whatever school that you end up, you know, going to or whatever, you really want to make sure that you have the opportunity to get your hands on equipment, you have your opportunity to get on people's sets and really learn all about, you know, being on film sets and learn about their goals and their dreams in the industry. And it's really just kind of something where you want to connect with a lot of the student population that you have there. And it's even a plus if you go to a school where you have a large acting pool, or if you have, you know, musicians that you can work with. It's kind of, that's the advantage of some of these schools that are more art focused. You have a lot of different creative talents you can pull from for all aspects of filmmaking. And then coming out of college, you know, depending on what kind of job you're looking for, there are a lot of jobs out there, especially kind of in the corporate commercial world, where to get onto these kind of video production teams for these companies and whatnot, you do need a four-year degree. You do need, you know, all this experience, and, you know, going through film school, obviously that's going to get you the degree, and it's going to get you the experience that you need. You know, I was able to get a job right out of college that, you know, one, required a degree and also required, you know, 5 years of experience. And because of the experience that I had and the portfolio that I had, I was able to kind of get in there without necessarily having the amount of professional experience that they needed. But something really important to consider if you are wanting to go to film school, you know, it's not just film school, especially if you're going to, you know, a typical university and getting a four-year degree. You're not just going to film school, you're going to college. So that comes with all the other stuff that comes with the college experience, that comes with all the other classes that you need to take, all like the general arts, all the gen eds, all the papers and all the other work that you'll have to do. And, you know, it's, in my opinion, it's very cumbersome, and it kind of takes away from your experience when you're at film school, because I don't want to spend my time working all this stuff. You know, I ended up spending more time kind of on my film classes and focusing on that, and it caused a lot of stress sometimes, because that would cause my grades and some of the work that I did in, you know, my regular classes to go down a bit. It really kind of forces you to learn time management, and you really do have to put in the effort in these classes, because it's not easy. It's, you know, it's not easy stuff. Every teacher that you have expects a lot out of you because you're at college, and it's supposed to be this kind of all-around general experience that you're supposed to learn. And then there's the social aspect of it. You know, you might have to move away from home, you might have to make new friends, you might, you know, there'll be social pressures like parties, alcohol, and all this kind of stuff. I know that's something that I struggled with definitely in the beginning, but it's something that you just have to consider. And if it's something that excites you, you know, that's great. If it's something that's a little worrisome, you know, it's something that you want to think about. Because you know, it's a four-year thing. And I mean, everyone has their own stories about how they get through college and school. But, you know, it is an experience. It's not just going to be your film school experience. It's going to be, you know, a whole change of life for 4 years if you go that route. So, you know, obviously you can do stuff like go to community college, and, you know, other avenues like art, more art schools that you give you kind of more of a specialized approach. But, you know, you got to be careful because, you know, you want to make sure you get the right degree and the right, you know, certification that you would need for the types of jobs you're looking for. So going to film school, I mean, it's, you know, overall, I had a positive experience with it. I know some people did not have a positive experience with it. In terms of the other side of the equation, not going to film school, well, the one thing I kind of wish I had in my life that I didn't have while going to film school, I wish that I entered the film workforce earlier, like right when coming out of high school. I would have liked to have more years where I was making more money and getting more actual professional experience. The film industry definitely is one of those industries that there are plenty of jobs out there that don't require, you know, having a degree. A lot of those types of jobs stem more into more of the freelance realm and the traditional film sets that you'll see kind of in New York and Los Angeles and whatnot, and because those really are based on experience and who you know. And if you're the type of person where you were able to get a lot of experience maybe through high school or through your childhood or whatever, making films and learning all about kind of the filmmaking process and stuff, and you've been fortunate enough to make, you know, a lot of connections in the industry and stuff, you might be in good shape without going to film school. You might be able to get yourself into a job and kind of work your way up the ladder. But if you're not going to film school, it's kind of more, you'll have to expect more of that kind of progression in your career. It's going to be more of that working your way up the ladder. It's going to be more of working on those kind of traditional sets and doing more of the freelance work, because there's going to be some jobs out there that don't have the degree that qualifies you for that. But, you know, there's definitely people out there that, you know, are talented enough and have the experience enough that they can get those jobs that might require degrees, you know, but you have to work extra hard for it. And that's another big thing. If you're not going to go to film school and you're going to enter the workforce right out of high school, it's something that you're going to really have to take seriously. Just as much as, like I said, when you're going to film school, you're going to have to really work maybe even twice as hard. And if you look at yourself and you say, yeah, I'm a really hard worker, you know, I can really do this, then, you know, that's great. Go for it. You know, if you have the knowledge and you have the experience and you know what you're doing, you can really make an impression on people. I even know people who went to college, you know, and studying something completely different, then ended up doing video production after they went to college and learning more about it. But you know, you lose out on a lot of the experiences that you can get at film school. Having instant access to all of this really expensive and really, you know, top-notch equipment, and having this full pool of other filmmakers around that you can really kind of experiment and play around with. You might not always have, you know, those type of people around unless maybe you're living in Los Angeles and New York. And I mean, I feel like, and in my opinion, if you're not going to go to film school and stuff like that, you're more likely going to have to move to a location like that so you can kind of surround yourself around the people who can help you. I believe it, you know, and some people say the same thing. Some people just aren't, you know, college material. Some people just don't want to go to college. Some people just don't want that experience, or they don't want to spend the money, or, you know, have the academic drive to do so. And there's nothing wrong with that. And if you feel like you're in this situation and you feel confident in your skills and think that you can make it, definitely go for it. Because everyone kind of has their own path, and you don't have to follow someone else's path just because they say that this is the way that worked for them. Doesn't necessarily mean it's going to work for you. And it really doesn't come down to necessarily if you go to film school or not. It's really if you put in the effort to get the experience and the knowledge that you need to really make yourself valuable to this industry. Because if you're valuable in this industry, you will get work. That's what it comes down to. If you can do something that other people can't, you will get work. You know, if you're friendly to work with and everyone likes you, you will get work. It really has to do with those things, not necessarily a degree that you have or the film school you went to or didn't go to. And you know, it really kind of sucks in this world that, you know, college is so expensive. I really wish it wasn't as expensive, because I know there's people who would have loved to have this kind of experience but just couldn't really afford it. So I hope all those rambling about, you know, going to film school and not going to film school really makes sense. And I hope that maybe there's something that you can take out of it if you're deciding to go to film school or not. If you have any more questions about that, or really any types of topics of filmmaking or video production, feel free to comment down below or reach out to me. If there's any other topics that you want me to cover in these types of videos, or if you want any more lessons or specific tutorials, about editing, camera work, visual effects, or anything, feel free to comment with those down below. Subscribe so you can catch the next video coming out, and be sure to check out CK Productions, my main channel, and follow any of my personal social media if you want to kind of keep up with the projects that I'm working on with CK Productions or outside of CK Productions. Like I said, this is kind of a busy time in my life. I'm doing a lot of balancing between all different aspects of my life, but I really am going to try to get these videos out pretty frequently for you guys. With that, I hope you have a nice weekend, and I'll see you for the next video. Bye, everyone.